Hello, I would like to continue about the thought power. So, I spoke about thoughts, the basic, one of the basic blocks of reality. I would like to add a few more things about important things about thoughts, thoughts cultivation. Thoughts can be transferred from one person to another, or one person to many other people, and the thought travels very, very fast. In a blink of an eye, the thought can travel the huge distances. No matter where you are on earth or anywhere else, the thoughts will be traveling in a blink of an eye. So imagine all the atmosphere around us is full of thoughts. When you go to dense populated areas like cities, you feel, if you are clear enough, if your mind is clear enough, you might feel the cloud of thoughts. You're less peaceful when you're in the city, because you're constantly receiving thoughts of all kinds. And depending, of course, on your attunement, on your level of energy, we are very much like a TV set in the way that we receive all the time endless messages. But we can willingly tune to a certain channel. We have this choice. The same way you pick up you choose a channel, certain channel in the TV, the same way we can tune to a channel inside of us. How is it possible to tune to a certain channel of thoughts? It all depends on the way you're trained to think and the level of consciousness you are in and the level of energy, which are all intertwined together. Every one of these components affects the way you think. When your consciousness is high, your level of consciousness, then naturally thoughts you are picking are more subtle, more sublime. And of course, if your level of energy is high, then your thoughts will tend to be more happy ones, positive ones. But we have this choice, which is every second of our lives, to tune ourselves to a certain vibration, to certain thoughts. It is a choice. There are situations where we are feeling like prisoners, where we can be in a bad mood and we think it is the end of the world and we have no hope. But there is always hope, and you should always be optimistic, because pessimism, thinking negative, will never be in benefit. Will never bring you a solution. It is only a cycle of going downwards, of losing. Even though you are in a sometimes in bad circumstances. Even though you feel stressed or depressed, then it's the most important time that you should work and try to change your thought pattern. Try to be optimistic. And there are very simple ways to begin to change your thought pattern. One simple way would be just opening the TV set and put a music channel which you love, or watch a positive movie. This will help you very much to change the mood you are in. So this is kind of like an external manipulation, an external suggestion, which can help you greatly. Music is excellent way to help you change your mood, because this reality was created by sound waves, and sound waves are very potent. They influence us very much. So thought cultivation should be practiced at daily, if you can, all the time. Try to be aware of the kind of thoughts you're thinking, and then try to, if you find out that your thoughts are not the way you want, then just try to tune to another level. Tune to a good channel. And once you begin to tune to a new channel, and then tune again, and repeatedly you're tuning day after day, after a while you're creating a habit. Habits will be created at about 30 days. This is the time when it takes to the neurons in our nervous system, our brain, to create a new pattern. And actually this pattern will replace an old pattern. So don't be discouraged when you're working, trying to change any habit you have. Be patient. Continue practicing. Be stable in your practice. Even if you practice just 10 minutes a day, 15 minutes a day, it accumulates. If you take 15 minutes a day, but you're in those 15 minutes, you are fully concentrated, you're fully committed, then the impact of those 15 minutes will be much greater in time. Time is relative. Sometimes we can achieve in 15 minutes things that we will not achieve in a few hours. So when you practice, practice with all your heart, with all your might, then your practice will be effective. So changing your habits for the good, for new ones, creating new habits, is changing your life, because you're giving up gradually the old patterns. Those negative patterns which you created as in childhood or in early times and whenever, some patterns are more difficult to change. But don't give up. You can change any pattern. This is your freedom. You're free to choose. You're free to change, and you can always change. Actually, we are constantly changing. Reality is changing all the time. This is the nature of reality. Reality is constantly changing. And if you're not changing, you're not in this flow of change, you are in like a stagnation. And stagnation means like slowing down your evolution, your emotion, your motion. Instead of vibrating in a high frequency, you vibrate lower. And then you kind of get stuck. So by realizing that we change all the time and trying to flow with the flow of life constantly, by letting go